I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face-off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept it A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me. Y'all can't stop me. This is forever. Forever, man. I mean that.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. Now on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got a bike. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Wentz now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. He'll get three up to midfield.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
From midfield, here's Wentz. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
On play action, it's Wentz. He can run for it, and he will. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Wentz can pull it down when he needs to, and the 6'5 quarterback picks up the first down. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first.
Anyone.
Throwing on first is Wentz. Going to throw right side here. Complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. In for the score. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Elliott now to kick this one away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10. Play action. It's Wilson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that block.
Dumps it off to Mixon. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Let's go get it right here.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Mixon with a first down carry. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Zebra, zebra.
On second down, here's Wilson. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Third and long, it's Wilson. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Now Wilson on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Now that's a great play defensively, and one thing we do know, both of the corners are going to face a lot of action in this game, the way that offense likes to fling it around.
The safeties, they better be ready to be engaged as well.
On third down, Wilson. Buying time to his left. And he's going to score. It's a Viking touchdown. Russell Wilson, his 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that will shave one more off this lead. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. To throw is Wentz. He's going to wind up and air it out. And got his man complete. A big play there for Philly. 62 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Line of scrimmage moves from their own 25 all the way to the red zone now for first and 10. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the... The Eagles into the red zone for the first time. They have a first and 10 at the 13-yard line. From the gun, it's Wentz. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
Hang in there,
an incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Let's go, let's go. 81.
That's it. Working from the gun, Wentz. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by DJ Swearinger. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They're trying to resurrect his confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game. And the head coach said, I'll take him. I'll fix him. The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, he's yours from now on. Someone has to take responsibility and work with him and try and get him settled.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, here's Mixon. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
He's going to fire one deep. And this will be caught at the 30. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. An excellent pick up of 34 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Over the middle, complete. It's Stone. He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down. Wilson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal. Here's the sneak with Wilson. And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Russell Wilson with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are able to strike for 6. And his kick is good. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. Left side. Touchdown, Philadelphia. As his guys are in for 6. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Such an electric play. So much fun to watch. And you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together. But that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field.
And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. On second down, Wilson. On the left side, a catch by White. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Now a play fake here on first down. Now he'll throw deep left side. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Will Fuller, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Vikings are going to take the lead. The fly route works for the TD grab.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving. And that's exactly what he did, all the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
This one fielded at the five. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field.
A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, and it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Back to the air on second down. Wentz. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And he's going to score. It's a Viking touchdown. Gold to add the extra point. Gold with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This one taken from the seven. Oh, a nice spin. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. The Eagles hustling to the line, clock rolling. On second down, here's Wentz. He drops it off for Bernard.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Wentz now 5 out of 10, 50% throwing it. Not so hot, but he does have a first down. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Black, black. Hey, stat.
Here, sit. Wentz will try again on second down. Going for the deep ball. He's got it with the 15. A big play there just before halftime. 42 yards.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And, partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime.
Hang in there now. Hang in there now.
Hey. Wentz to throw on second down. Quick hitter here. It's complete. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Now to try the Eagle field goal, Jake Elliott. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Elliott puts this one through. And that gets them back within 10. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Final 12 seconds of the half now as they've got it first and 10. Here's Wilson to throw. He's going to look deep down the field. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Second and six, just inside the 30. To throw on second down, Wilson. Flush to his right. Yeah, he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down. They got the win last week despite not having any interceptions. Tried to come up with one there, could not. But there's a stat category called PBU, pass breakup. That's important too, and they got one.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, because at least you're there knocking the ball away. Offense isn't possessing it, making plays downfield. And you just continue to harass the receivers, harass the quarterback, and maybe the big play does occur down the road.
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Tempo, baby, let's go. Let's go to work. Come on.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Touchdown, Vikings! A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what. Well, his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these
are the Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away, because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Throwing now is Wentz. Going up top. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
And now out comes Minnesota. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be, but we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards.
14.
They go play action now. Wilson. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Stone. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. A good pickup there, a 22.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Play action with Wilson. Over the middle, complete. It's Stone. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. In a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic. This is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
And an alley to run! And he's able to get up here to the 26. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know. And go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Wentz gonna throw. Just keeping the play alive. That is incomplete.
Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Once again here on second and 10. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
You know they wanted, you know they expected. They needed him to be sharp coming out after the half. Unfortunately, he's missed his first three throws. I wonder if he got out late and missed his warm-up time.
The whole team did come out a little bit later than usual. I don't know, maybe there's something to that.
Must have been a heck of a halftime speech.
Yeah, maybe just trying to rally the troops back from this deficit.
Wins. Dancing to his left. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
Hang in there.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They do go for it. It's Wentz. Throw left side complete. It's Norris. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. Yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That good for six as they keep this drive right on rolling. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Tackle made by Eric Kendricks. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range. And guess what? They've got a shot.
Tackle made there by Tony Jefferson.
And while there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Here's Wentz to throw. Rolling to his right. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on 3rd and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Wentz now on 3rd and goal. And that is incomplete. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle. As a visiting team, as an underdog, you were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
Now Wentz, gotta have this one. Escaping the... And he'll score! Touchdown, Eagles! Carson Wentz, his 2nd touchdown of the night. And the Eagles get a score closer. And that was just an old-fashioned scramble play, fourth and goal, and he willed his team into the end zone.
And I just don't know how, on the other side of the ball, you keep your composure. You account for everything. You defend everything. And this guy finds a way to make a play on you. Can you tell? That just agitates me a little bit as a former defender.
I know your hands are shaking.
And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Vikings now heading onto the field. Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well.
Mix it in, and all the ball is out.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Again, it's Mixon. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and two now. Fake. Here's Wilson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Here's a give to Mixon, and he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll stay on the ground, Mixon again, and a short gain there down to the 37 yard line. The Pro Bowler Fletcher Cox there to get him down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, he's just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Vikings, they move back over 500 at 7-6. And they'll return home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, you wonder what this will do to their playoff prospects as they fall to 8-5. And they'll be back home next week for a date with the Washington Redskins. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Okay, I'm back to school. You, this is open campus. This is, I should slap a open-handed. Just like I told a model, she need lower standards. Ask her if she had a twin, I feel like Joey Tanner. Chris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, what's happening? Think she call me, think she, cause she never knew her daddy. And my dog black, Rhythm Nation, Janet, boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, what's underground? What's underground? Frontin' like a ride with the mob, why shouldn't I charge? Me, myself, and I. Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll, holler them all. Strutting like Pac out the court, hop out the Porsche, shake that, got that card. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was ganging since the platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being Hova, I should move EA. Listen, babe, listen, so good you'll think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing, I could Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy being truthful, baby. Baby, for real. Overload. This is like I got like my pinky. Money, baby, we don't, baby, it ain't ours. Bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style. Chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF chains down. I gave